The heteronormative view of history. A basic definition of heteronormativity is that it is the idea that anything heterosexual is normal and natural, while anything that is outside of that is deviant or is just ignored. The history that I was taught growing up was based in the view of heteronormativity. This is because the historians that made that history usually only come from a worldview that is white, cis, straight, and male. They don't have the view of what it is like to be queer or a gay man or trans. They don't understand what that kind of life is like. Queer people have always existed, but they have not been accurately represented in history because of homophobia enforced by a heteronormative viewpoint. For instance, this picture shows lesbians that were in a bar in the 1920s. There was a lesbian scene thriving that time in New York, but it was put to a stop by police officers that would raid the bars. Context effect is the theory that environmental factors affect the way that we perceive stimulus, meaning that historians have avoided queerness in their history because they did not have the traits to perceive it. Since they live in a heteronormative society, they do not know how to define anything that lives outside of it. Schemas also affect people's perceptions. Think of a child that has only known their parents and their dog at home. They only have the perception of human beings and dog as the main beings on earth. So what if that child is taken to the zoo and they see all these different animals, but they don't have context for what those animals are? So instead of saying horse, instead of saying hippo or giraffe, they just call everything dog. This is not because they think it's a dog necessarily, but it's because they don't really have another word for it. Historians also have not always had the words to describe queerness, so instead they will misinterpret relationships as straight, or think that a queer couple are siblings or friends instead. One of the many examples of this is the tomb that was excavated in 1964. The hieroglyphs on the wall revealed the men with their noses touching, which usually is meant to be kissing. Historians at the time did not understand this and interpreted the relationship as close friends or brothers. Another reason that history can be heteronormative is because of conformity. Conformity is defined as social influence that causes people to change how they behave or their values in order to fit into a group. Not all historians are blindsided by queerness. They can tell what is going on, but do not want to label it. This can be from religious belief or fear of what the reaction may be from the public. One relationship that led to conformity is the relationship between John Lawrence and Alexander Hamilton. They exchanged many letters together. When family members of both families found the letters, they were censored. Parts of Hamilton's letters were burned or ripped out. They may have wanted to save their fathers from bearing the burden of homophobia, but because of that, we lose a piece of queer history. Thankfully, some of the letters still remain, and you can see the longing in Hamilton's letters to Lawrence. Cold in my professions, warm in my friendship, I wish, my dear Lawrence, it might be in my power, by actions rather than words, to convince you that I love you. Another example would be the depiction of the AIDS crisis. Growing up, the AIDS crisis was the only thing I knew about queer history, and even then, it wasn't really depicted as queer, just a tragedy. The lesson that I got on the AIDS crisis was brief, and we mostly talked about Ryan White, a straight white kid in a suburban town that received AIDS from a needle. This sanitized version of history is not what I needed as a queer kid, and it's not what we should be representing to other people. History is much more colorful.